CYFRFM, life changing, powered by FEBC Radio.
This is Ann Graham Lotz with Daily Light for Daily Living. In the Old Testament, Judah enjoyed 52 years of peace and prosperity. Instead of using those years to grow strong, the people of Judah had drifted far from God. Their disobedience to his word, their disregard of his precepts, their defiance of his law were provoking his judgment. At this critical time, God raised up Isaiah, the greatest of the Old Testament prophets. But he didn't become great until his head knowledge of God dropped 18 inches to his heart. The unforgettable moment when he exclaimed, "I saw the Lord," in Isaiah 6:1. Listen to me. I believe we're living in a generation that desperately needs to see the Lord. We need a fresh vision of God. We've become arrogant in our disregard for him. We too are provoking his judgment. So be an Isaiah, someone who speaks forth God's word with the power to change lives, a power that is rooted in your own personal vision of the Lord. This is Ann Graham Lotz.
Disinformation is spreading alongside the new coronavirus. To counter this, it is important to share information that comes from reliable sources, such as health authorities and the World Health Organization. During the COVID-19 outbreak, only trust official information sources and credible media outlets. Do not share unverified information. This is a message from UNESCO.
And you're on Up 987, life-changing, bringing you songs and messages that encourage and comfort amid the pandemic we are in today. Go ahead, invite family and friends who may not know about the broadcast. And here's to hoping that what you'll hear will remind you to hope in the Lord. It's been almost 2 months of being under quarantine. And even if some restrictions have been lifted, it's still scary and dangerous out there, especially that there's no vaccine yet. May this lead us to continue praying about this unique situation that we are in. Be confident that the Lord hears, He listens, He is our help. Our time is now 6:35 a.m. I'm Gail, and I'll be back in a few minutes. Meantime, let's give you more songs. Coming up next is Dave Pettigrew for Undertow, followed by For King and Country for Joy. This is your FEBC Radio.
It's dark, the water's crashing over me. The cries are washed up on the beach. But no one hears a sound. I take a breath, I breathe you in. I take a step, I can't begin. Cause I'm still caught in this headwind. This ship has run.
I'm getting caught in the undertow.
watching the nightly news. Don't seem to find the meaning, just want to send the blues. Feels like a song that never stops. Feels like it's never gonna end. Gotta get that fire back in my bones before my heart turns into stone.
Next is Chris Tomlin for the song I Lift My Hands, which was released 10 years ago. He co-wrote this with Louis Giglio and Matt Maher. It's about lifting up our hands in surrender to God, reaching out to God for help. May this be your resolve amid this pandemic we're facing.
Be still, there is a healer. His love is deeper than the sea. His mercy is unfailing. His arms a fortress for the weak. Let faith arise. Let faith arise. I lift my hands to believe again.
Yeah.
On YouTube who are watching our streaming, thank you so much for allowing us to spend time with you today, and we pray that you will be encouraged as you listen to the songs and messages we play here. Enjoy your day.
Ang ilang pang tadhanang inaasam natin, pero patuloy pa rin ang laban patungo sa kapayapaan. Pagkakaisa, tumakay, may pagkakaiba. Di lang pera ang yaman, pati pag-ibig sa ating bayan. Pag-asa ay sagana, pagdating sa pangarap lahat may gana. Panahon na para lahat ng ito ay tumangin, dahil ang Pilipinas ko ay Pilipinas muli. Bayan ko, bayan ko, walang iwanan, Pilipinas natin to. Alam ko, bayan mo, bayan ko, bayanihan, ipakita natin to. Dahil ang bayan ko, o bayan ko, walang iwanan, Pilipinas natin to. Hindi ka na mag-iisa, tama magsama-sama. Thank you.
Hello, this is Grace Nemanuel, station manager of Up 987 DYFRFM Life Changing. Today we experience one of the most unprecedented crises in our generation. In a span of just 4 months, a tiny invisible virus compelled us to close borders, schools, businesses, and churches in more than 100 countries around the world. Many people are riddled with fear and worry at everything that's happening around us. We here at DYFR FEBC continue the work that the Lord has started in us. We see this as an opportunity to encourage people whose hearts are now open to seek God. We bring the message of hope and peace we can have in the midst of any storm through faith in Jesus Christ. As you may already know, Up 987 DYFR is a non-commercial, non-profit, and donor-supported broadcast station, and we are not spared from the impact of the COVID-19 pandemic. In fact, we now face the possibility of implementing drastic changes in our broadcast operations to be able to cope. While we continue to trust our faithful God, who is sovereign over the work that we do, we have seen His grace for the ministry through your giving. And now we ask if you would consider helping Up 987 DYFR-FM stay on the air through your financial support as we look to the future. DYFR has been in operation for almost 45 years, bringing the message of God's love to listeners here in Cebu and around the world. We fervently pray that the Lord will allow us to broadcast beyond 45 years. If you would like to join us in continuing the music and powerful biblical messages, get in touch with us through our mobile numbers 0919-492-1939 or at 0998-842-3844. You may also contact us through our Facebook at www.facebook.com/up987DYFRFM. Thank you for your help in our mission of communicating Christ in our world, on air, online.
Thanks for letting me join you this lovely Tuesday morning. I'm Gail for Up 987, Life Changing, one of the 12 stations of Far East Broadcasting Company Philippines. And if the broadcast has encouraged you in some ways, as what our station manager Grace Nemanuel mentioned a while ago, we ask if you would consider helping the broadcast ministry by partnering with us financially. To know how, message us on facebook.com/up987DYFRFM or text us at 0919-492-1939. And to those who gave to the station, we can't thank you enough. We appreciate the partnership. May God bless you. Our time is now 6:53 in the morning. Let's give you another local track called Sinugdanan by Augmented Seventh. Thank you so much for tuning in. Enjoy your Tuesday.
Ikaw ang Diyos. Brangenberg of I Work For Him, the voice of the faith and work movement.
It comes as no surprise that less than 20% of Americans regularly attend church. But just about all Americans have a job. So So we could say that not everybody has a pastor, but just about everyone has a boss. So how will the other 80% of Americans find out about Jesus Christ if they are not stepping into a church? The current population of the U.S. is 327 million. So that's 262 million people that we can witness to through our daily interactions in our jobs. You are the one that has been chosen. You are Christ's ambassador for such a time as this. Today, won't you pray and commit to be Christ-like at work to everyone you work with?
For more about I Work For Him and our vision to transform the workplace of every Christian into a mission field, go to iworkforhim.com.
Today's May 19, 2020. This is your news to this hour. I'm Gail Lagadia for FEBC Radio. Once public transport operations resume in areas under general community quarantine, the Land Transportation, Franchising, and Regulatory Board has said all public utility vehicles or PUVs will be required to keep a record of passengers. LTFRB Chair Martin Delgra III said this measure will help in contact tracing in view of the continued threat of the coronavirus disease or COVID-19. Mr. Delgras also encouraged the commuting public to keep their own records of the PUVs they ride. In other news, the Department of Health has recorded 205 new cases of COVID-19, bringing the country's total to 12,718 on Monday, May 18, 2020. More than 80% or 145 cases were located in Metro Manila, while 1% was recorded in Central Visayas. Meanwhile, 94 patients were able to recover from the deadly respiratory disease, raising the total number of recoveries to 2,729. On the other hand, the country's death toll has risen to 831 with 7 new fatalities. And that's the news to this hour. This is Gail Lagadia for FEBC Radio. Check your time. It's now 7:02. Good morning.
Going from strength to strength through your partnership. This is FEBC Philippines, marking 71 years of communicating Christ in our world. Zamboanga City.
1116 VXAS. Your community radio.
Davao City.
1197 DXFE. The Good News Radio.
Coronado City. 1062 DXKI. The friendly voice of South Central Mindanao. Cagayan de Oro City.
103.3 The New J. Your positive choice.
Tacloban City.
97.5 DYFE. First response for the community.
Bacolod City.
1233 DYBS, the sweet voice of salvation.
Cebu City.
Up 987 DYFRFM, life changing.
Quezon, Palawan.
106.3 DZRK, Radyo Kapitbisig,
Legazpi City.
CARE 104.3 The Way FM.
Santiago City.
1143 DZMR Missions Radio,
Metro Manila.
98.7 DZFE, The Master's Touch,
Mega Manila.
702 DZAS, Agapay ng Sambayanan.
On air, online, on the ground, going from strength to strength.
Inspiring, life-changing,
staying firm through the turbulence,
up 987, up 987, encouraging, inspiring,
you just gotta
up 987.
Hey Hey, you're listening to Up 987 DYFRFM, life-changing, broadcasting live from IBC Compound, Manawat Hills, Cebu City. My name is Gail, keeping you company till 9 this Tuesday morning. We're now down to our second hour together. Thank you so much for joining me today. A few months ago, I finished reading the book You and Me Forever by Francis and Lisa Chan. There's a portion of the book that talks about prayer, and I want to share that with you today. Listen to the exact words, and I quote, "Our prayers reveal a lot about us. Our requests show what we treasure, and our tone reveals our view of Him." Close quote. Now, I'm assuming that a lot of us have more time for prayer these past months and weeks. I'm hoping that a lot of us have been more serious when it comes to praying. But if you were to evaluate, what do your prayers, your requests reveal about you? How do you sound when you talk to God? Do you sound humble or do you sound demanding, as if commanding God what to do? Well, some things to ponder on this quarantine season. Let's get back to music. We have here a song by We Are Messengers called Magnify. May this truly lead you to magnify the name of the Lord.
I've been trying to make sense of the sorrow that I feel, holding on for life to the only thing that's real. I've only scratched the surface. I've barely had what it takes. Just a glimpse draws my heart to change. And one side of you will lay my sins to waste. I need to see everything. Just more of you.
Take it all away. Magnify no other man.
Open up my eyes to you.
Take it all away. Magnify no other name.
Open up my eyes to you. My sight is incomplete and I made you look small. I've been staring at my problems for way too long.
Infinite wisdom on the whole.
Stanley Bannister, take this woman, Patricia Loretta Carlson.
Patricia, Patricia.
What?
I've been meaning to tell you something.
What?
It's nothing big. I forgot to sign out when I left the military.
You're a deserter?
That's the technical term for it, but it's really just a misunderstanding.
I do.
You're telling me now?
All I wanted you to know before we got married.
You're a criminal?
I'm not a real criminal.
And you? Sure.
We'll just need to move every few years.
Why haven't you cleared this up with the authorities?
Well, it's not like I ran away. I just needed my space. I mean, there's nothing wrong with what I've done. Dear, it's your turn to say I do. Dear?
We all excuse ourselves for the things we've done, but we're not excused until we've asked the one we've wronged to forgive us. Since we've all sinned, have you acknowledged your need for God's forgiveness? Another message from Lifeline Productions, the comic strip of radio, and lifelinepro.com.
Dear
words that warm the heart.
Up 987.
Brad Paisley, Lauren Alina, Tasha Cobbs, Leonard join Stephen Curtis Chapman for the song Together We'll Get Through This.
I can see the panic in your eyes. I know you can see it in mine. We've been through some crazy things before, but nothing like this. You know I've always got a lot to say, but this has left me nothing but afraid. And I've got one thing I'm holding on to, and it's your hand. 'Cause I believe together we'll get through this. Together.
It's all or nothing.
say goodbye. It's time to save the world.
Mornings are always inspiring here at Up 987 DYFRFM. Life changing.
Jesus told a story about a bunch of religious folks who got together for dinner, and a prostitute crashed the party. Now, that was a dumb prostitute. Any prostitute that goes to a party of Pharisees is out of her mind. At any rate, she wanted to be next to Jesus, and Jesus never turns anybody away. Here's what Jesus said about her, maybe about you and me. Those who are forgiven a lot, love a lot. If you're pure, good, and righteous, you're probably a pain in the neck. But if you're one of the sick ones for whom Christ died, you've probably been forgiven enough to love enough. I'm Steve Brown. You think about that. Share what you just heard with a friend. Go to youthinkaboutthat.com.
Hero of the day.
Hi, I'm Ferdinand Miguel Becerro, and I'm a theater scrub nurse at the University Hospital of Southampton. It is a government hospital here in the UK. On my shift, we mostly do heart surgeries, but sometimes I get assigned to care for critically ill COVID patients in the ICU who are intubated. I mean, I know, it is frightening to be in direct contact with those patients, and it gives me paranoia that I might have contracted the disease after every shift. It's also depressing to witness a lot of people dying. But I cling to God's promise that he will not leave me nor forsake me. And that faith I have in him encourages me to go to work every day.
Hero.
We're thankful to our dear frontliners. Please continue to pray that God will continue to give them strength as they go into the COVID battlefield. Our time is now 7:32 a.m. Gail here, and you're still hearing inspiring songs and messages from this FABC radio in Cebu City, Up 987, life-changing. We're a member of the Kapisanan ng mga Broadcaster ng Pilipinas. Well, before the government's order to stay at home, were you rushing through everything and somehow living in nothing? Did you make moments matter? What are you doing this month to grow your ability? What are you doing this week to make a difference in someone's life? What are you doing today to savor the gift of life God has given us? Well, as what the Bible says, life is just a vapor. So treasure every moment you have. You might not have a white flag indicating your last lap on the racetrack of life, but I encourage you to live like it's your last go-around and savor every turn. Again, make moments matter. This next track is called Head Above Water by Avril Lavigne.
Gotta keep the calm before the storm. I don't want less, I don't want more.
And my
Ultimate love.
God's love.
Tune in to Up 97. Life changing.
Life-changing.
Tyler, and in this time of uncertainty, I think it's important for us to focus on the things that we can be certain of. 1 Peter 5:7 simply says, cast all of your cares upon him because he cares for you. And those cares can be interpreted as fears or anxieties, worries or stresses. So in this time where we can feel isolated and alone because we're quarantined to our homes, may we remember that we're never alone because God, Emmanuel, is with us. In that time that he is right beside us, right next to us, he is telling us that he is a safe place for us to place all of these fears on. So right now, know, in the middle of your fear, in the middle of this uncertainty, he is with you even then.
And our time is now 7:49 a.m. Hey, we appreciate that you're with us today. This is Up 987, life-changing, broadcasting online too through the mobile app FEBC PH Stream. If you don't have this app on your phone yet, download this now on Google Play. And we want to say hello to some of our friends who are listening this Tuesday morning. Hi to Miss Lucille Beatingo, to our chief technician, Kuya Noel Ubod, who dropped a comment on our YouTube channel. Good morning also to Divine Balbinero, who says hi to her family at the Tabalong Dawis, to the Balbinero family who's tuned in to Up 987, and to your kids as well. A good morning to all of you. Thank you so much. I'm Gail. I hope you're safe amid the COVID-19 pandemic. I understand that this health crisis is really making us feel anxious and scared, that sometimes we want to make drastic decisions. Perhaps you've considered looking for a new job or transferring to a new location which you think is safer, or maybe you've been finding ways to earn on top of the full-time job you have. Don't get me wrong, these actions aren't wrong, but if you haven't consulted God about this, then maybe you should think twice before making those decisions. You see, it's always best to consult God first. The Bible says, do not lean on your own understanding, but trust in the Lord with all your heart. So before making any drastic and major decisions, trust God first. Consult him first, ask him, Lord, is this what you want me to do? And when he gives you the answer, That's when you make your move. Coming up next is Faith for the song Sidlak.
Drag me down. Successful man take early retirement. He had made enough money to live comfortably and leave an inheritance for his children. However, after he retired, he began to wander aimlessly. He became a busybody, meddling in other people's affairs. We should live our lives in perpetual motion toward fulfilling our purpose. That's not to say that we shouldn't take days off. God ordered the day of rest, reflection, and recharging. But that's very different than shifting our energies down to a crawl and becoming lazy or busybodies. Remember, don't retire from your purpose. To learn more.
Today is May 19, 2020. This is your news to this hour. I'm Gail Lagadia for FABC Radio. President Rodrigo Duterte says the Department of Science and Technology, or DOST, has been in talks with six Chinese and Taiwanese organizations and research groups for possible clinical trials of a COVID-19 vaccine. President Duterte said the DOST has conducted exploratory talks for possible involvement in the clinical trials with the Chinese Academy of Sciences and Sinopharm in China, Academia Sinica, the National Health Research Institute, Chang'e University, and Adimmune Corporation in Taiwan. The vaccine, being developed by the Chinese Academy of Sciences, Sinopharm, and the Wuhan Institute of Virology, has entered the second phase of clinical trials, with 96 people being given the experimental vaccine. In other news, PAGASA has said Filipinos should brace for frequent thunderstorms in the coming days. PAGASA weather specialist Ariel Rojas said no weather disturbance is expected to affect the country in the next 3 to 5 days. However, he clarified the dry season has not yet ended. He then advised the public to drink plenty of water, avoid drinking tea, coffee, or soft drinks, and limit physical activities from noon to early afternoon to avoid heat stress. And that's the news to this hour. This is Gail Lagadia for FABC Radio. Check your time. It's now 8:01. Good morning.
From strength to strength through your partnership. This is FEBC Philippines, marking 71 years of communicating Christ in our world. Zamboanga City,
1116 DXAS, your community radio.
Davao City,
1197 DXFE, the good news radio.
Coronado City, 1062 DXAI, the friendly voice of South Central Mindanao. Cagayan de Oro City,
103.3, the new J, your positive choice.
Tacloban City,
97.5 DYFE, first response for the community.
Bacolod City,
1233 DYVS, the sweet voice of salvation.
Cebu City,
up 987 DYFRFM, life-changing.
Quezon, Palawan,
106.3 DZRK, Radio Kapitbisig,
Legazpi City.
CARE, 104.3 The Way FM.
Santiago City,
1143 DZMR, Missions Radio.
Metro Manila,
98.7 DZFE, The Master's Touch.
Mega Manila.
702 DZAS, Agapay, Pansambayanay.
On air, online, on the ground, going from strength to strength.
Inspiring. Life-changing.
Stand firm through the turbulence.
Up 987.
Up 987.
Encouraging. Inspiring.
You just gotta
live. Up 987.
Good morning. This is Up 987 DYFRFM, Life Changing. We're an FM station of Far East Broadcasting Company, Philippines, and a member of the KBP. I'm Gail, and just like that, we're now down to our last hour together for this episode. It's no surprise when people are losing a lot of patience these days, especially when a lot are anxious because of the health crisis and everyone's been affected. And majority are forced to lock themselves up in their houses. Sadly, because of this impatience, we get blurt words that aren't really helpful, words that hurt, words that leave deep wounds. We don't want to add to people's problems, especially that we're in the middle of a pandemic. So I want to share with you some insights from a devotional book I was reading in the past. And this talks about some characteristics of wholesome words. Wholesome words build people up. They are grace-giving and are spoken at the right time. So do our words hurt or help those closest to us? Reflect on that question today and make necessary steps to improve. Let it be your goal to speak wholesome words, to speak life, all right? We have here a requested track. This is for you, Divine, Waymaker by Michael W. Smith, featuring Vanessa Compagna. I trust this will reassure you and comfort you.
You never stop working.
Sunshine, I hope I join. Oh, Jesus Christ.
is Up 987 DYFRFM Life Changing, broadcasting from Cebu City.
Hi, I'm looking to serve God.
Wonderful. We could use help in the nursery.
Not into diapers.
Well, how about greeting people at the door?
Too smiley. Don't you have something better?
Teaching Sunday school?
Too much work.
Serving soup at the rescue mission?
Ew, too greasy. Don't you have something that would impress my fellow Christians, wouldn't let my friends know I go to church, and it would be nice if I could do it in front of the TV? Got anything like that?
Not if you want to serve God.
Another message from Lifeline Productions, the comic strip of radio, and lifelinepro.com.
Oh. no one else like you, Jesus. You crush the darkness, you raise the fallen. There's no one else like you.
broadcasting from Emmanuel Bible College compound, Banawat Hills, Cebu City.
Who can bring you into a living relationship with God? Here's Pastor Colin Smith with today's key for unlocking the Bible.
You can't bring yourself into a living relationship with God. It doesn't happen through your experience, your discipline, your integrity, your generosity, or even your prayers. And the church can't bring you into a living relationship with God either. The church can teach you the Bible and it can offer you friendship, love, and support. Only Jesus Christ is able to bring you into a living relationship with God. He gave his life for you and he can live his life in you. Christ died for sins once for all, the righteous for the unrighteous, to bring you to God. The gospel is good news from Jesus Christ, about Jesus Christ, and he is good news for you.
You've been listening to Pastor Colin Smith of Unlocking the Bible. If you'd like to hear more, visit our website, unlockingthebible.org.
Who is allowed outdoors during the quarantine? Only one person per household can go outside to buy necessities, such as food and groceries. Also allowed outside for work are employees working at markets, groceries, convenience stores, drug stores or pharmacies, and banks or remittance centers, and personnel in health services, border control, or any other critical service. Senior citizens, pregnant women, and individuals with health conditions such as hypertension, diabetes, COPD, or cancer should stay indoors. A reminder from the PCOO, VOA.
And our time is now 8:33 a.m. Hey, 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 thanks for giving us a listen. We're up 98.7, life-changing. That's 98.7 on your radio dial. I'm Gail, happy to join you today. And we want to say good morning to Ate Catalina Bakotot and family, to her daughter and son-in-law, Dale Joseph Dolliment in Canada, to Pastor Chito Aquino in Vancouver, Canada, to our friends at CCBC Liloan, Pastor Felipe Singuran, Sister Maritis, Attorney Jojo Ortega, Pastor Alin Tan, Pastor Fred Bulani, Pastor Joseph Press, Pastor Ruben Solante, Pastor Manny Pepito, Pastor Lee Birth and Family, Pastor Miguel Visitacion, and to Sir Johnny Gulpan. Thank you so much for tuning in today. Good morning also to Sir Fred Pardorla, and he says hi to our listeners in San Pedro or San Isidro, Dumlog, and Poblacion Talisay. Thank you so much for spending time with us this Tuesday morning. If you're following us on Facebook, we posted some insights on how to fight anxiety about life after quarantine. You know, after months of isolation, we don't know what awaits us. The world outside our doorsteps isn't the same anymore, and that's scary. So we shared some ideas on how to fight anxiety about life after quarantine. And let me share a summary of it, like reaching for support, continuing to practice self-care, and listening to music. You know, May is Mental Health Awareness Month, and this is a good reminder to evaluate how our hearts and minds are doing, especially with the recent situation that we are in. If you want to read the whole post on how to write or how to fight anxiety about life after quarantine, you have to go to our Facebook page to be able to do that. And if you want to share your insights too, feel free to comment it on the comment section. All right, we have another song here by Laura Story. It's called Grace Abounds. This is your FEBC Radio. Thank you for tuning in today.
Everything around me shaken, and trials tempt me to despair, and I feel like my own heart has hardened toward sorrow that's too great to bear. When life has left me disillusioned, hostility and hatred seem to win. Each headline that I read brings me to my knees again. When it feels like hope cannot be found, grace abounds.
Thank you.
Let me problema, I'm a
Yes, Mrs. Yu. Yes, nag-program ako, Mrs. Yu. Opo, nasa station, nag-program. Okay, Mrs. Yu. Thank you, Mrs. Yu. Bye. This is Up 987, Life Changing, your FABC radio in Cebu City. We want to say hi to our friend Trisha Yvonne Ruiz listening through our YouTube streaming. Thank you so much for tuning in today. And she shares this passage, Psalm 31:24. Be strong and let your heart take courage, all you who wait on the Lord. Thank you so much, Trisha Yvonne, for sharing this encouragement to all of us. Now be reminded that God loves you so much. We are sinners, broken and flawed, but because of His love for us, He rescued us and gave us another chance in life. He redeemed us and gave us hope to carry on with life. We know that life is not perfect or easy, especially that we're facing a health crisis now, but with God in our lives, we are guided, comforted, and loved. My name is Gail. Again, remember that you are blessed, for you are loved, so have faith. Enjoy the rest of your Tuesday, and if there are opportunities for you to help, grab that opportunity. Be a blessing to the people around you, especially that we're in the middle of a pandemic. God bless you guys.
I know.